Good morning, everyone. My name is Robin Dolezal, and this is Alex Pars. Good morning, Alex.
Good morning, Robin.
We're with Ironwood Financial, and today we wanted to talk about annuities. We had a client come in just this week who has recommended that they buy a new annuity. So let's back up first before we get into why that may not be a good idea, but let's first talk about the different types of annuities, okay? First type of annuity is your pension type of annuity, which really is just an immediate annuity. That's where, you know, you give the insurance company $100,000. That asset is no longer yours. In return, you actually have a monthly income of, say, $700 or $800 a month until you pass away, okay? Great deal if you live a long time. Unfortunately, if you pass away in the next few years, you know, that money is again gone. There's no more money for your beneficiaries. The next type of annuity is a deferred annuity, and there's many types of deferred annuities that we want to talk about. Many flavors, if you will. The first one, it would be a fixed deferred annuity, which is much like a CD, right?
And that's what this client was actually recommending.
Right, absolutely.
When he came in this last week. So what this product was he was going to go out and put this money in for a period of 7 years, okay? And if he took it out any time before then, minus some caveats, there was a penalty. For that, the insurance company was going to guarantee him no less than 1.5% per year, and then the first year, they were actually going to pay him 2.2%. Okay.
I think it was just 2.
Well, it could have been. Either way, that's probably less than inflation.
Right.
Okay. So that annuity, once it lasted for the 7 years, then you could take it out, roll it to another annuity, turn on a cash flow, do whatever you want with it. But you do have that penalty period for the first 7 years. Quick question, Robin. Mm. Do you want to invest money for 7 years at 1.5%?
No, not at all. No, not with today's interest rates.
That, my friends, is the reason that annuities, while not inherently evil, are probably not a good deal today.
Right.
Okay? And they probably won't be a good deal for years to come. So basically, any type of fixed annuity is in some way, shape, or form tied to current interest rates.
That's right. With the Fed funds currently at 1.5%, we've got a 10-year treasury at 2.7%. There's really no reason for us to lock our money out for 7 or 10 years for that long.
Or even longer.
Right.
Okay. Again, do you want to take your money and invest it for 30 years at today's interest rates? Does that sound like a good idea?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. So there are other types of annuities out there, and the way that annuities are being sold today is not based on their, call it, inherent merits. They're being sold based on what's called a rider, which offers a 6% guarantee for 10 years and then an income stream for the rest of your life or something like that, okay? What you need to understand about that money is not money that you can actually access, okay? That 6%, you can't say, all right, I'm gonna put 100 grand in, 10 years from now, I got $170,000, give it to me. They won't do it. That's because it's a phantom account. It's called the income value. It's not your account value. Okay, so if you want to take that money out in one lump sum, you can't.
Right.
Plain and simple. What you can do, however, is take it out in the form of an income. And they limit the amount you can take out per month or per year to something like 5% per year. So, for example.
And that's what we call annuitizing.
Or even with these riders, they have now a way of doing it without annuitizing, just generating a minimum withdrawal benefit is what they call
it. Okay, yep.
Okay, but here's the fun thing. I could guarantee you 20% per year rate of return and still pay you zero or still pay you 1%. Okay, that's what these insurance companies are actually doing. And let's break this down. Okay, we take that $100,000 and they're giving you 6% for 10 years, guaranteed, no ifs, ands, or buts, unless you take it out early. Okay, so you let it sit there 10 years, because who wouldn't want 6% in this interest rate environment?
Sure.
Okay, so now you've got $160,000, $170,000. Again, you can't take it. But what you can do is you can take, call it 5% out of that. So you take 5% out of that, that's $8,000 per year. $8,000 per year, guaranteed for the rest of your life. Okay, now let's back up a second. You bought this thing probably when you retired. Let's call it 60. You waited 10 years. Now you're 70. Now you start taking an income stream of $8,000 per year for the rest of your life. Okay, your account is no longer growing, by the way. It's fixed solid at that $8,000 per year. So now, let's say 10 years go by. You've gotten $80,000. Okay. We're now 20 years into this contract, and you've gotten back 80 of your 100.
Right.
Okay. Let's go out 20 years. Mm-hmm. Okay. We've been taking an income stream of $8,000 a year for 20 years. Okay.
So and that's. Now you're 90.
You're 90 years old. You've taken $160,000 out of an investment that you put $100,000 into 30 years ago. Is that a good rate of return?
No.
Not at all. That's less than inflation. So even though the marketing brochure said you're guaranteed to get 6% per year for 10 years, they lock you in for the rest of your life. And even if you're lucky enough to last till you're 90, you're still not earning hardly anything. Okay. In fact, I did the math on these, and the average one of these annuities, if you live to average mortality, is offering roughly a 0.5% interest rate on your investment over your lifetime.
That's terrible.
That is. So again, you have to be very, very careful. As my mom always said, if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. The banks are paying zero. The government's paying two. Insurance companies are paying six. What doesn't work?
It doesn't sound right.
Insurance companies don't like to write checks.
No.
Okay? They're not doing this out of the goodness of their heart. They're doing this to make money. And the reality is, it's smoke and mirrors. They're paying you far less than you think you're getting.
Right. So I guess the point is not to bash on annuities. I know it sounds like it is, but we're really talking about in today's environment. Again, Alex mentioned that it's not that they're inherently evil. It's that today's interest rate environment just doesn't lend itself to lock your money up for so long for that low of an interest rate. Now, if interest rates do go back up, I mean, I remember my grandparents, Alex, had great annuities that were paying them 8, 9, 10%.
Absolutely. And there's even double-digit ones.
Right.
Okay. So when interest rates are back up, annuities once again will be on the table, if you will. But today, you're locking in low interest rates for the rest of your life. It's a bad idea.
That's right. If you like that topic and you want to learn more, if you have any questions about other topics, come visit us at ironwoodfinancial.com. Right now at ironwoodfinancial.com, we have an ebook that talks about taking income from your retirement portfolio. We also have a webinar that talks about the biggest risk to avoid while in retirement, which is a great resource. My name is Robin Dolezal. This is Alex Pars. Until next time.